You should force no one to become Muslim. He lied against the Catholic. I expose him. If you speak to me, speak that human being.
Don't be scared.
He's running away again.
Listen, Daniel, I have to be honest with you. You guys are non-Arab speakers.
Why do you always hide behind the Arabs?
No, this is one rendition of the hadith. So it says that this doesn't have numbers though.
That
hadith explains that it's a dhikr from Malaik al-A'la. So which means...
But that hadith that you've never given us anyway.
Proof is there.
Not dead.
But Muhammad didn't tell you this because he's an antichrist.
On the cross, right? Resurrected on the third day.
Yes, a prophet of the devil.
He's alive now.
A prophet of the devil giving him all the carnal desires. Women, money, lust, child sex, booty. Right? Is that something that God's going to give you? Come on, people.
Don't be afraid.
You all want to be understood. You all want to be loved by a true and living God. How can a prophet, like Muhammad come along and do the things he did and came to be holy? How? How can he go to 600 Jews after they surrendered to him and dig trenches and then chop all their heads off? How? This is not a prophet of God. This is not a prophet of God. And this Muslim has nothing. He needs Jesus Christ. No, you can't speak because this is the time of the Holy Spirit. Right? Jesus. See, can you believe this? So Jesus commands everyone, including you, sir, to repent. Repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Turn away from your evil, carnal desires that Muhammad is telling you is okay. Right? How many wives you got?
I've got one.
Do you want four?
No.
Why not? The Quran says you're going to have four. Would you marry a child?
No.
Why?
Would you?
Your prophet did it.
So did John.
Oh, hold on.
Joseph.
That's a copa.
I know. Prove to me in my Bible that Joseph married or copulated with Mary. Prove it.
No proof.
The reason they've got no proof is because it's not in there.
Okay.
But in your hadith,
your
al-Bukhari, the most prominent hadith you have, it says that Muhammad looked at a 6-year-old girl and lusted after her.
Whoa.
What kind of a holy prophet lusts after a 6-year-old girl?
Jesus was a Jew, right?
Would you lust after a 6-year-old girl? Would you lust after a 6-year-old girl? No. Would you? No. Any other Muslim? Would you, sir? He's not Muslim. Nobody. No. He won't answer. The reason he won't answer.
Why?
The reason he won't answer is because he's disgusted. He's disgusted at the behavior of his prophet, and he cannot criticize the Christ.
Ask a question.
In the name of Jesus.
What do you think about your God?
Right.
Wait. Let me ask a question. What do you think about your God?
Let me ask you a question. You're coming into my space. Yeah. Run away. Too hot for you in here. No.
Come back.
I want to ask him a question. He's always smash and grab. This is a smash and grab. Come to make a point and run back. You answer my question. Come and defend your God against Shamsi.
Come, brother.
I'm asking you. Come then, brother.
Come on then, brother.
Defend your prophet. Come on then, defend your prophet in the name of Jesus.
Your God is inside
no,
human.
Right. Your God. Find the shaking. Look at the hands. Reason is shaking because it feels the power of God, the power of the Holy Spirit, standing right here preaching the truth. Every one of you, be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
Come on, answer my question.
Okay.
How is your God doing inside the woman's vagina?
Before you start
to be baby.
Before you start to be baby.
How is your God?
Before you start to be baby.
Jesus Christ is solid. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus Christ don't move for no one. Chico, you know why?
Yes.
Because he is the truth.
Yes.
And he loves every single one of you.
Yes.
He's waiting. He said, behold, I stand in the door and I knock. Open up to Jesus and he will come and dine with you. He'll forgive you for your sins unconditionally.
Yes.
Do not be afraid.
Yes.
Come to the truth. Hallelujah. In Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You are a liar. You are not the same.
And you're running away.
What you said.
I show you.
I was
going
to shout you.
Page 37.
No, you're a liar. You're a liar. You're not going to get it. You've been exposed. You've been exposed. That educated exposed you. That educated said, force people to become Muslim.
Yes.
Okay.
All people of the world. I show you.
Again, he said, Ibn Kathir said, force people to become Muslim. He's been the biggest liar ever existed.
That's good. Expose him. Shamsi,
you're talking about yourself. But you said I'm the biggest liar. You are talking about yourself.
Expose God to him. That's not good. He said, Ibn Kathir said it. Again, he's lying.
Okay,
Ibn Kathir is clearly. That's what Ibn Kathir said. No, no, bring me the book.
I showed you the book.
Bring me the book.
You wrote the book and you ran away. You wrote the book.
Excuse me, it's haram to have a dog, but if you want to be my dog as a human being, no problem. Come follow me.
He runs away. Let him go. Let him go.
Tafsir ibn Kathir. Yeah, I brought the book last week. And Shamsi ran away.
Okay.
I didn't bring the book today, and he's saying, bring the book. And he's running away now. I'll give you the reference. I always have the reference on my phone. This is what it says, yeah? All people of the world should be called to Islam. If any of them refuses to do so, what does that mean? If they refuse to accept Islam, kill them or they have to pay jizya. If anyone refuses to do so or refuses to pay the jizya, they should be fought till they are killed. Reference. Listen to the reference. Muslim. Listen to the reference. Tafsir ibn Kathir, part 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 253 to 286. And Surah Al-Imran, ayat 1 to 92, abridged version by Sheikh Muhammad Nasib Arifra, page 37 to 38. I'm not the one lying. It's your own sources that say it. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He's not a liar. He's the truth. You need to accept him. So we don't need to lie. We don't need to deceive anybody. We expose the lies. Come to know the truth. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
We obviously want to ask you a question.
I can pray for me as well as he prays for Muhammad.
I can pray for me as well, please.
the book already. He showed you the book.
Yeah, so we're going to ask you that question after. Okay? Okay?
Tell
Allah to pray for me too.
Yeah, remember to ask Allah to pray for me.
Allah to pray for you as well.
I saw a film as well.
If you don't pray for me, it's okay.
I will ask Allah to guide you today.
Pray for me.
Ask Allah to pray for you. He needs to ask Allah to pray for you.
Yeah, Allah to pray for me.
Remember, Allah prays for lots of people.
Yeah, he prays for lots of people.
Allah should be able to pray for Godwin. He's lovely gentleman.
I need Allah to pray for me. Will he pray for me?
This is Christian mockery.
No. Will Allah pray for me?
Alhamdulillah.
No mockery, bro.
Shamsi won't say Jesus on the time.
Ask Shamsi. That's what you think he said.
Will he pray for me?
Okay, but wait.
He's not answering the question.
No, wait.
Will Allah pray for me?
How does Allah pray?
So what does that mean?
I'll ask Allah to guide you.
Right, so why did you say
Allah doesn't pray the way we do pray? So can you just expand that?
Yes.
Is that means Allah doesn't do the voodoo? Is that means Allah doesn't do the ghusl? Is that means Allah doesn't do the salam? So what does Allah does different? Does Allah skip the morning prayer?
Give me a bit of a question.
Well, of course, Jesus Christ did all of that, didn't he?
Yes. And the direction
of
What has to do with my question? We want to know what type of prayer Allah prays.
I know, it's very
funny. Did he find the Quran? Did he find Islam funny?
Allah, creator of everything.
I like your new jacket.
Yeah, I like your new jacket as well. But let's deal with the thing. So we want to know how does he pray?
I already talked to you about it.
Explain to us.
Again.
Okay, last time. So when Allah says, Salli.
This is the direction he was.
No,
really?
So the word salli in Arabic, it's a verb that depends on the thing that's being described. So for instance, if I say that ana usalli, I pray, yeah, that could mean I make dua, I pray in the sense worship. That Muslims pray, that they whatever. It could mean that I ask for supplication. So it has an array of meanings. When it's applied to the angels, it has a different meaning. So in the case of the angels, it means supplication. In the case of Allah, when that same word is used, it means blessings, salutations, blessings and so on. And the evidence behind that, and the evidence, remember before we were talking about, like, how do we know what the Arabic language is, and how can we prove that what I'm saying is true, for example, in Arabic language. So I said to you that, we have to look at the pre-Islamic time. We also have to look at 300 years after Islam. So in other words, from the Prophet died at about 11 AH, so about 300 AH. So when we look at that, we find that in the poetry that's used, the word salli, when it's applied to Allah, even in non-religious contexts, it means praise and blessings. Blessings. When I say praise, I'm talking about praising. I'm not talking about praying. Okay, so that, I think that.
We got your point. Can we respond to it?
You can try it.
Let me respond. Yes. First of all, thank you for confirming that angels are making dua, and according to Islamic tradition, Dua is the essence of the worship. So angels are worshipping for Muhammad. Okay?
No, dua means supplication. So I say like, I'll pray for you.
Dua is the supplication. And according to Abu Dawood, according to Islamic tradition, supplication is the essence of the worship. So now listen, sir, listen, sir, listen. Listen so that we don't have an issue with the pray and praise. I've got two English speakers here. They should be able to help us out.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not that great.
No, they're all right.
So,
they're all right. It's been
humble. So don't bully him now. Just wait. I'm just responding. So can you just please provide the second word in the Surah 33 verse 56, where same word used for angels and then the second word used for Allah.
Good question. Good question.
Because in that sentence...
I mean, you go say it again. He didn't hear you. Say it again.
Yeah. Why not? Doesn't he bring his ears to speaker's corner? Daniel, don't insult him. He brings his ears to speaker's corner. So...
You're speaking.
Surah 33 verse 56.
That's funny.
How many Yasaluno is used in that verse?
Say again. How many what?
Yasaluna.
How many that Arabic word is used in that verse?
Which one? Whichever question?
Yasaluna.
Don't
you know,
that.
So the verse goes, Saluna comes one time.
So the one we are asking, where it says Allah and his angels pray for Muhammad, used only once.
Yes.
Okay? So how many groups we have? We have Allah, I don't know what you call them in English.
Allah
and angels.
The angels,
and there is only one Yasaluna for them. Okay?
Yeah.
So how come that change to Allah, for Allah and for Muhammad?
How come
that same word, how can it change when it's applied to
Allah? There is only one.
Yeah, that's okay, one word being applied to Allah and to angels. Yasaluna. It's the same. You said one word.
Yeah.
So when that change happens, how can it change meaning? It's the same word.
There is only
the same word for both of them. Did you get the question?
You get the question.
He did get the question.
Yeah, okay.
Allah and his angels, yusalluna ala nabi.
Yeah, same word.
And then it says, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi. Sallu.
We have Allah and angels.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, how come it changes?
Why is the meaning changing when it's both? So, is it the same? What Allah and angels are doing are the same? Are they the same?
Are you talking about Saluna?
Is what Allah and the angels doing the same? Are they doing the same thing?
Oh, okay. No, I understand your question.
I feel like I should go to Cambridge and teach now. No.
You went to university, though,
don't worry about that. Just ask the question.
So, as I said to you before, when the word is used, let me give you another example, okay?
Don't give us the example.
Just deal with the answer. Right. You do this all the time. You always do this. Come on, just answer the question and come out.
So, Yusaluna, when it's applied to Allah, it means something different to when it's applied to the angels.
And where does it say that?
Where does it show that? Show us.
Yes, that's how the Arabic language works. So, for example, if I use the word...
It uses the same word.
Exactly, but according to who does it change?
Okay,
perfect.
Let's break it down. Let me just break something down.
He asked the question. Can I answer the question?
Answer his question and I'm going to break down something for you.
So he said according to who, right? So let me give you an easy example. The Quran says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيهَ نَفْسِهِ. Whoever يرغب, عن إبراهيم, whoever goes against the way of Ibrahim, except for the one who has become foolish. Yeah, the word used here is يرغب. But when the same word is used in other contexts, it means yarqabu means to like something. So the same word is used, but the context determines.
It's so simple.
It's in the same verse.
We don't have to go around the house.
He asked a good question.
Yeah, but you haven't told me.
You're going against your Quran.
According to you,
show me how
Yusaluna changes when it's applied to Allah.
So deal with the Quran.
I want you to deal with Surah 56.
No, I understand, but you need to have a preamble as to how the Arabic language works.
You're just waffling around the question.
Okay, fine, you have to have a preamble, yeah?
Yes.
Can you tell me that you saluna?
You're rejecting my premise, though.
I'm going to make a point, which will be helpful to you, okay? So, Quran is well detailed, well explained, there is no contradiction in it. Quran is given to man who cannot read and write. Quran is given to man who couldn't even identify the voice of Allah. Are you trying to tell us Allah didn't know the knowledge of Arabs in 7th century and then he made everyone so confused, he put one word in one sentence yet put, do you call them subject or object?
Subject, two subjects
and one word and then expected in 21st century people to just understand that word changes from one person to other person while well detailed, well explained, while Muhammad had no problem for Allah to pray.
So here's
no,
my
no expert.
Right, so the Arabic words in the Arabic language, like for example the word yarghabu or the word yusalli or other words, amara, ya'muru, which means to give, in its base form means to give imperative command. It depends on the context in order for it to be explained.
But we give you the context.
So in other words, what I'm saying is that depending on who the fa'il is, because you have, in Arabic language you have fa'al, which is the verb, and the fa'il is the one who is the doer, the word itself takes a different meaning. So that's my premise. My premise is in the Arabic language, and I can give you examples of that in the Quran, I can give you examples of that before the Quran, I can give you examples after the Quran, that one verb, depending on who the fa'il or the doer is, can change in meaning. Now, for you to move forward in this conversation with me, you have to disprove my premise. You have to disprove the fact that one verb in the Arabic language can take a different meaning when applied to different doers. Can you do
okay, Muhammad, the question we asked is that word yusalluna used for Allah and angels.
Yes.
You said it's different when it's applied for Allah and angels. Yeah?
Yes.
And we're saying according to who is it that the meaning changes when it's applied to Allah and angels?
So
you haven't answered. According to Islamic sources,
asking non-Islamic sources.
Non-Islamic sources.
You're answering from a non-Islamic source. Yeah. So
not from Islamic source.
Both Islamic and non-Islamic.
So give me the Islamic source that says this is sunnah, this word,
yes,
when it's used for Allah,
yes,
and when it's used for the angels,
yes,
it's different.
Okay. There's a hadith on it.
Sean, let's get it out. Let's get
the hadith in Bukhari.
We got Bukhari. 21st century.
Yeah, so that's a good question.
I've never ever seen you use a reference before, ever.
Let's get the reference out.
Let's get the reference.
I've never, ever, for a long time. So Sahih Bukhari, the hadith is
well known.
Sahih Bukhari, volume.
I'm going to give you better scholar.
You want to give you the Arabic language?
We can bring it out.
The 21st century.
Right, so
21st century, you know, we can get anything.
No problem.
Google.
So Allah says, whoever.
No, we want the reference! We want the reference! We want the reference!
There are 7,299 Bukhari hadith there, okay? So which one is this one?
Okay,
so give us the reference. Numbers.
Book number five,
Bukhari.
The numbers are different depending on
the... Right, so give us the one you know.
Give it to Google, sir.
See, Muhammad never ever gives reference.
Let's go to Google.
Are you going to give us the reference?
I'm going to give you the hadith and then you can find it yourself.
No, we want the reference.
Sahel Bukhari has 9 volumes.
You know it. So give us the reference.
10 volumes, I'm sorry.
But even though, the thing is, in Arabic, you don't have numbers like that.
No, but...
Okay, so what is the reference?
You do this with
the so you're just going to say, as a reference, you're just going to say,
So I'll say it in English, so you know the hadith, right? The hadith says that whoever prays upon the Prophet, sends prayers on the yani salutations and so on, like yani the salli ala man salli ala nabi, yeah, whoever sends, says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example,
yeah,
that Allah he mentions him in a malak, in a higher setting. With the angels.
Can I
hadith, therefore, according to the hadith says, the hadith explains what the word salli means, respect to Allah. It means al-dhikru fil mala'il a'la. Al-dhikru fil mala'il a'la. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fil mala'il a'la, which means that it is mentioning that person's name in a higher station. So in other words, it's a praising, not praying, but praising that person. That is a hadith that you ask for that reference.
Okay. No. Muhammad hijab. That sounds like a deviation.
Well, maybe to
why?
You
first, why a diversion? Yeah. Because we asked you the word Yusalluna,
yeah, it's in there. It's
and you said it's in Sahih al-Bukhari. Yeah, you did not mention Yusalluna in your response. Okay. You mentioned Sali,
well,
and then Allah the and his angels, when it's applied to Allah and his angels, so hadith, being different. That's our question.
Listen,
so in Sahih al-Bukhari doesn't say it.
I have to be honest with you. You guys are non-Arab speakers.
Why do you always hide behind
the
Arabs?
You don't know about the
Hadith. You're not giving us. So right now, why won't you give us the reference?
Bring it some
Arabs. If you don't mind me to allow this to be an education. Okay, you cannot, you don't have the one thing you need to know.
I can't get educated
without you. You haven't even
I'm pushing the teacher if he doesn't have reference.
So simple, so easy. Ask them to bring in any Arab Christian missionary like them, and if he found any problem with that,
so
well, for 1400 years,
I am going to make it much simpler.
Any problem with any Arab speaker,
no one exposed
you. Let's simplify.
When the David Wood debate came up in Arabic and it was translated. Just look at the comments. People are laughing at him.
Let me make a comment.
The waw and the noon refers to the pluralization of that root.
Okay.
It's making it plural.
But is the answering when it's used for Allah is different? When it's used for Allah is different, it's not answering.
No, I've explained to you now. That hadith explains that it's a dhikr from Malak al-A'la. So which means...
But that hadith that you've never given us anyway.
So it doesn't exist. You don't believe it?
We don't know.
It doesn't exist.
We are on Google. We're asking you to give us.
All right. Go and do your research. The number of the hadith...
Hadith is not in Sahih Bukhari. Hadith is not in Sahih.
Have you found
the
hadith?
Yes, I found it.
Oh, here we go. Okay.
That's what I told you.
Sending
salams upon the Prophet. It was narrated by Abdullah said. The messenger
Abdullah
of Allah said,
which Abdullah?
Allah has angels
Abdullah,
who travel around on earth conveying to me the salams of my ummah. Is this the one you are looking for?
What's the reference?
Okay, give me your Bukhari version.
Let me get it.
What's the
reference? He's going to get it. All right. So we're going to fight about time. Yeah. This is the first time I've ever seen you. We're actually going to have a record, a world record.
By the way,
broken in speaking school. He's going to give us a reference.
Okay.
No, but we'll give it to
you. Is he David the prophet?
Stop, right? You're desperate. And stop being racist.
Government, while he looks for the reference, I think Muslims could acknowledge with me, Muhammad is the best scholar you ever had alongside of Allah. Therefore, if we are looking for the definition, if we are looking for the definition, then we would go to Allah and we would go to Muhammad. Besides going to 21st century missionaries, Muslim missionaries, or 21st century scholars, when we go to Muhammad's teaching, Muhammad identifies the word as the prey. Okay?
P-R-A-Y.
When we go to Sahabayas, who so-called Sunni Muslims are following, they identify the word as the prey.
P-R-A-Y.
So, if Muslim wants to discredit,
Umm Jamil crazy.
No IC supporters.
This wife Abu Lahab.
We don't like IC supporters.
Yet they want to go to the pagans. We love to see that how they want to put
okay.
Let me open it.
Okay, so we're going to get the hadith out. So
yes, let's open it. Yes, sir?
There is plenty mobile in there.
So what do you want? Yeah, crazy.
No, I support you.
You're a liar.
And this is one rendition of the hadith.
So this doesn't have numbers, does it? Sahih Bukhari has been translated to English. It shouldn't be that difficult. It shouldn't be that difficult.
Give me hadith for Jesus, you liar. Give me hadith for Jesus. You liar, women. You crazy. Go to hell, yeah, don't
Jesus
be.
Loves you.
Allah.
Jesus loves you.
Allah.
Kamar of Allah.
Allah. Allah.
Representation of the Islam. I'm not correcting it, bro.
La ilaha illallah.
He's representing
Allah.
And I Once again,
Allah!
Yes,
you brief, my friend.
La ilaha illallah. After tomorrow.
Let me speak.
Muhammad Rasulullah.
Shut up, you liar.
But he got
to say. I'm not going
to move away because Muslims
are. I'm liar. And shut up. Look at the filthy mouth of these Islamic
guys. Obama, yeah.
So what we see, what's happening?
Guys, have a problem.
You're being very inconsistent.
Subject.
Very inconsistent.
So, Surah 23 verse 56 emphasize in the context Allah and angels are praying for Muhammad. All Muslims, you've got to do the same thing.
No.
Allah, creator of everything,
you
is praying for Muhammad.
You're lying, you're lying now. You're lying.
He
doesn't say pray, he says he's sullied. The Sunday didn't say
pray. That's what they got.
He doesn't say pray.
Muhammad was not able to give us scholars. Muslims should agree with Christians.
No, we don't.
Muhammad is their best scholar.
That's right.
Sahabis are their best scholar. And so-called Allah is another best scholar. According to Muhammad, according to Sahabis, according to angels, according to Allah, Allah does pray for Muhammad. We don't go to pagans. We go to Allah and we go to Muhammad. According to them, they do pray. Have you noticed? Even though all of the Sahih Bukhari has been translated to English, yet Hadith, which is supposed to be in the Sahih Bukhari, angels are carrying the prayers to Muhammad, somehow couldn't come out.
Because
that says a lot.
Person,
and what happens is, he has lots of enough time with the hecklers, with the harassers, still Hadith did not come out. And he walked away.
By the way, he brought the hadith out. We don't know what hadith he brought out. It was all Arabic. No numbering system. We asked, where's the number? He's like, oh no, the number is not there. I'm like, excuse me, we're living in the 21st century. Of course the Bukhari has numbering system. We know he was like, and then we have Auntie
Jamal.
There is a problem, Muslims.
Allah.
Teachings of the Quran is affecting your eternity. Teachings of Muhammad is affecting your eternity. And as a Christian, we do concern for your eternity because our God concerns
for you. Ignore me. Desperate.
Who was it? Was it on camera?
Yeah, it's on camera.
God of Bible gives us the solution for the souls of Muslims. God so loved the world that he sent his only son.
Amen.
For his son to die on the cross for sinful people. Muslims, you've got to repent and come and worship Lord Jesus Christ, King of Kings, Lord of Lords.